Hello and welcome to the Funkitpod MediaCast. It's Friday almost, and it's time to talk about what happened in the media this past week. And if you watched, listened to the previous pods on Fridays or close to Fridays, then you know I've always talked about Myanmar in the beginning, and this is not going to stop because, quite frankly, the coup in Myanmar isn't stopping, and so is the media censorship, of course, that's not stopping. The internet still cut most of the time, so that's also not stopping, and the security forces, however they call them, military, is still gunning down people. Like, I think a day ago or two, they gunned down around 80 people in a town close to Yangon. So it's not stopping. So if they don't stop, we can't stop. So again, I urge everybody watching, listening to this, even if you're getting tired of me saying this all the time, the people in Yangon or people in Myanmar are certainly also very tired of what's going on right now. So they deserve our... I don't want to say prayers because, yeah, sure, but I mean, they deserve our attention and that we try to do something here. So if you can do something, do something. Don't just ignore this because that's what they want, right? That's always what happens in situations like this. They're like, okay, there's going to be an outrage for a few weeks, but then it's going to die down and we cannot let this happen. So please be aware of this. Tell everybody, tell the politicians that you can influence that they should do something against it. Don't forget about the people in Myanmar that are fighting for their lives right now, quite literally. Okay, but since we are here, so we obviously also talk about all things that happened in the media this past week. And I have a few headlines just to also look at the lighter side of the media once in a while. And one thing that stood out to me that I just read while I was setting up my recording studio equipment here, so to speak, was that the Friends reunion shoot is apparently underway because Matthew Perry had a revealing Instagram post. I hope he didn't reveal too much. It's interesting. So I did like Friends when I was growing up, just like many other people. I do also understand why lots of people in 2020, 2021 say, that show might not be the most representative. Because it's not, obviously. But then back then in the 90s, that wasn't that much of a deal, I assume, right? I wonder how they're going to handle this now. Are they going to keep going in the form of Friends the way it used to be? Or are they going to be more woke, more PC, and won't have Jordan Peterson tune in then? Questions over questions. I'm looking forward to it. I'm curious to see how I'm going to enjoy it. Will I enjoy it? Will I not enjoy it? So I'm just curious to see if it's going to happen, when it's going to happen, and so on. Let me know what you think about this. I think that something that's a little bit more critical is Joe Rogan in the news again, this time not for being transphobic. this time I read the news. Someone just picking up those old news, like streaming giant Spotify quietly deletes Joe Rogan podcast. And interesting here, I think, is simply that the fact that they try to make it bigger than it is, I think. But then again, I mean, Spotify did delete certain Joe Rogan episodes with like Alex Jones, with Milo and so on. So that's interesting. And does that hurt Joe Rogan's credibility? Yeah, that's an interesting question. I mean, he probably doesn't care that much about credibility if you have a $100 million whatever dollar contract, right, for like, I think, a decade or whatever. So I don't think he cares too much about that. But I mean, he looks like, or he talks like he would care about it. But then again, I don't think he cares about what other people are saying. It's just... like someone's always like, I just say what I want and I do what I want. And then the company says like, yeah, you can do that as long as we are cool with it. It's a bit weird, isn't it? I would like to see Rogan just talking about and saying what's up. Not sure if he will, but yeah, that's just a bit weird. I also don't agree with like all the articles coming out right now and like trashing him like, oh, look at this. I mean, that's just what happens when you sign with a company, right? And, I mean, they want to stream your stuff, your content, but they don't have to. So they pay you, so they, of course, they can pick which shows they have on their platform and which not, right? I wonder if you can just put up the shows that are not on Spotify, if you can put them up on YouTube. Probably not. So anyways, that's interesting. Also happened to the Andrew Schulz podcast when Alex Jones was on there like a few weeks ago, I believe. And then that podcast disappeared from YouTube. The video just disappeared from YouTube. Of course, some of the assholes, that's how they call their fans, they downloaded it before and so on. So it's still online, but YouTube deleted the Alex Jones episode from YouTube. I think they were citing medical misinformation or something along those lines. Obviously, when Alex Jones is talking, there must be misinformation in there, right? All right, so yeah, I'm curious to hear what you think about this. A few other news before we go into deeper waters again. Apparently, there were some fake Clubhouse for PC app ads on Facebook. Facebook found out about them and then killed them, of course. But interesting. I mean, I also found lots of fake Clubhouse for Android download now and stuff like this. When you Google for it, you find it, right? So be aware, people. Right now, there's still no Clubhouse for Android and for PC so be aware of this. Keep your eyes and open and minds sharp. Obviously, that's nothing that's there yet, because Clubhouse said it's going to take a month to develop an Android version. I don't think they're going to work on a PC version anytime soon, which they actually should be doing. Is it really worth the a few billion dollars then, is the question, right? What else are we curious about? Well, Coinbase, because right now, if you haven't seen, check your crypto prices these past 2 days, because they are through the roof once again. Bitcoin surging, Ethereum, so everything is going up. XRP through the roof, insanity. So Coinbase, right, the leading platform where you would trade coins, is going public. We talked about this last week. And now the question arises, are they there to stay? Is it going to be like something that revolutionizes the way we trade? Or is it something that's cool for a while and then it disappears again? Right now it looks like it's the revolution, right? But you never know, because everything was cool for a while. Like Blockbuster Video was cool for a while until Netflix came and said, go away. So we have to wait and see. Like, all the crypto stuff is very interesting, very fascinating. Also, of course, complicated to understand. Hashtag NFTs. Hashtag Mark Cuban. Because Mark Cuban, owner of Dallas Mavericks, multi-billionaire who owns different, I think, Web 2.0, is this still a thing, startups as well. He said, and I wrote it down so I don't misquote him, he said, Ethereum will dwarf Bitcoin as the crypto market hits $2 trillion. So he says once Ethereum goes to Ethereum 2.0, once they reveal the update, it's going to go through the roof and it's going to go like crazy. And he goes all in on Ethereum. And well, if Mark Cuban does that, that seems like a pretty good call, I believe, right? What else do we have? Well, Twitter said like, hey, Clubhouse, you're cool and we have our spaces, but we can just take you and we offer you money. And apparently, and I also wrote this down, they offered $4 billion to Clubhouse to acquire them. $4 billion. Then it didn't work. So now we have spaces, Twitter spaces. Which is a stupid name, by the way. It's Twitter. Twitter Spaces is not cool. Twitter Spaces is just, it's not a cool name. Rebrand that ASAP. If you need help, call me. So what it's very interesting, because you would figure it's easy to create such an app, such a Twitter space. But apparently they were interested in owning Clubhouse. Okay. Well, okay, here's a funny one in between that I saw the other day while I was, I think, on the way home from the gym or something. Apparently, Dubai deported a group over nude balcony shootings, photo shootings, not shootings, but photo shooting. So there was a group that had like a nude photo shoot on a balcony and got deported. Apparently, this were Ukrainian women and a Russian man. Interesting. So when in other countries, right, be careful. This could also happen to you here in Thailand if you ever come over to where I'm out of. So please be aware of this. Okay, there was just a funny bit in between. Should be like a segment of the funny bit. Okay, back to the less funny bits, but the very interesting bits. China, first country to create their own digital currency. Whew, congratulations. Like their own, other countries have like bonds and stuff in crypto, like Germany, for example, has like crypto bonds, I believe. But now China came out last week being the first major economy to have their own digital currency. Congratulations, China. Probably totally anonymous, right? yeah, you think about this. I saw an app, a new dating app, not that I need one, a new dating app that, and let me check the name, Vinily. It's based on Spotify-based dating app. So if it's really important for you that your match also listens to Wonderwall when he or she is sad, then Vinily is the place to go. what else did we have? What else did we write down? Oh yeah, I'm with my Clubhouse. I'm all over the place today just because I have so many Clubhouse pieces of info that I saw this past week. Payments are now on Clubhouse too. So now if you're a Clubhouse creator, you can make money on Clubhouse. Ooh, this had to happen. Now it happened. Influencers now gonna run to Clubhouse even more. Is this already the end of Clubhouse? I don't know. When that happened really fast, right? That they have the monetization feature now on there. Was it all just a plan to find a way to make as much money as fast as possible? Not a big fan of this. Let's see how that really reflects on Clubhouse. If there's now just more BS talks on there just to make some money. All right. We talked about crypto a lot today as well. Just as an add on there. Signal has now cryptocurrency payments in their app, which is kind of interesting, I believe. I think Signal is the first messaging app that does that. So good on them. Cool. Good job. Today I saw that, speaking of first, that WWE, a wrestling company, it's WrestleMania season, by the way. More on this Monday wrestling, or Wednesday, Wrestling Wednesday. That WWE released their first NFT, so you can buy wrestling NFTs. For like, I think the cheapest one is like $100, but then it goes up to 100,000. Like an Undertaker NFT, like what? Can I create an NFT podcast? I'm gonna look into this. Before I look into this though, let's finish the notes here that I noted down that I wanted to discuss with everybody here that is so graciously spending time with me listening to this. A cool thing, again, funny bits here to them. A cool thing that I saw was just a new toy from Hasbro. They have like this Transformer toy, and yeah, I know I'm too old for this, but it's $700. So, I mean, who's going to buy this for their kids? You buy it for yourself if you buy it. If you're single in your 40s, you buy it for yourself. It's Optimus Prime, and it can transform on its own, like Autobots, and you don't have to do it by yourself anymore. Isn't that cool? It's super cool. I just felt like I had to talk with someone about it. And since none of my friends would understand me, I talk with you about this. What I found very interesting, though, for real this time, that China actually fined Alibaba, and let me check again, $2.8 billion after an antitrust investigation. Just say, think about it. China fines Alibaba $2.8 billion, USD in this case, after antitrust investigation. So the Chinese government investigates Alibaba, says, hey, we don't trust you. You can't be trusted. Do you think that's real? Or do you think that's just like to show to the outside world, like we investigate our own and you can trust us? I think it's the latter. Because, I mean, come on. We're on, not the moon, we're on Mars, right? We know that we're on Mars. Hey, NASA Ingenuity, they wanted to fly the helicopter, but it's been pushed to Wednesday, is what I read. So, yeah, helicopter flight happening soon. That's going to be exciting. And I'm not even kidding. I think that's pretty cool. It's pretty exciting. So you go, NASA, you go. I like it. A few other news before we wrap things up already. Facebook spent $23 million on Mark security in 1 year in 2020. $20 million, $23 million. What is he so afraid of? If Facebook would be awesome, it wouldn't need to be afraid. Just saying. I'm glad he's safe, though, of course. Mark, you go. We have, speaking of antitrust, Alibaba in China. There's another antitrust case in Australia. And this time it's not Google. This time it's Apple. Like, this time Australia is like dishing it out. Like, yeah, mate, you can get it, mate. You can get it, mate. You just come over here, mate. You get it too, mate. Everyone gets like slapped with the court orders in Australia these days. And I like it. You go, Australia. You go, ooh, Aussie, Aussie, Aussie. Let's see how this goes. So this is going to take forever, probably. So let's see. Let's keep an eye on this. Let's update again next week if there's some progress. That's going to be happening for a while, I believe. Okay, let's, before we wrap things up again in a more lighthearted manner, a very serious thing is that there have been more than 500 Alphabet employees, the parent company of Google, right? And they demand that Google stops protecting harassers in an open letter. So apparently it happened a few times that employees, they came to HR and said, hey, I feel harassed by my coworker or by my senior supervisor or whatnot. And then HR made them have like one-on-one sessions, like where the person that harassed talks to the harassed person, the harassee to the harasser sort of thing. You know what I mean, right? What? That's ridiculous. And you would think Google is like woke and open-minded and so on, but apparently that's not the case. And apparently most of the time, if that's right, what's in this article, that the person being harassed is usually the person that leaves the company, while the person doing the harassment usually stays in the company, which is also weird. That feels wrong, of course. If that's always true, needs to be verified. Because, of course, emotions run high and people say things that you don't know. Maybe he or she is just mad right now and just exaggerates. Who knows, right? But anyways, that this comes out and it's like more than 500 people actually saying, yeah, I think that's true and we should do something against it, is pretty insane, I believe, right? So Google, don't be evil. What's up? Last thing that I wanted to just throw in here in the podcast, and then we move on to brighter and bigger things, hopefully, for the rest of the week, or you will enjoy your weekend, hopefully. Indiana Jones 5 is set to come out, set to hit theaters in July 2022 with Harrison Ford in the main role. Harrison Ford, can he still do all those? I mean, of course, he has stuntmen and stuff like this, but how convincing will Harrison Ford be in this role, I wonder. But I'm a sucker for all things Indiana Jones. I mean, after all, university professor, adventurer, kinda. So I'm all for all things Indiana Jones. Let me know what you think about Indiana Jones. Also, since last time this worked rather well, I got quite some interesting and positive feedback, so thanks for this. I will add another deep dive 10, 15, 20 minute video in regards to some media theory. Last time we did Moral Panics, like a week ago or so. Just received some nice feedback, so I appreciate this. Thank you very much. So I'm going to do another one. Let's see how that goes. If you want to hear more, just let me know. I'm happy to do those calls. I'm happy to talk about all things media, communication studies, and so on, of course. All right, that's it for the Funkit Pod for what happened in the media this week. If I missed something, please do shout out. Let me know what you think about all the topics discussed. If you want to hear something in particular next week, shout out as well. Until then, stay safe, take care. And I'll see you soon.